Hi, I'm Annabel Williams. It's my pleasure to be here today at ACM to do a Q&A masterclass. Thanks for having me. This National Youth Jazz Orchestra I was telling you about, I would go every Saturday morning. My music teacher would drive me up from the little village where I was from, and we'd get really early. We'd go every Saturday to London, to the Big Smoke, and there was this 23-piece, 24-piece big band rehearsing every week, and I would go along with my charts, and they'd have charts there of songs, and I'd sing with them, and I was like, this is amazing, like no other singers are here. And I went for about 3 or 4 years on my own every week, you know, and I'd be in my little room learning my charts, and then I'd go out to the big room where they all were and sing. I was completely intimidated by them all and never really got friendly with them for ages, you know, not till we started gigging together. Anyway, so I thought, I should tell other singer friends about this. They should come down. So anyway, I started telling people. And what eventually happened was, quite by accident, I would sort of help them because I'd already been going there. And one of the girls was like, God, you explain it so clearly. You should teach. And I was like, really? So she was like, will you teach me? So I'd teach her for £5 an hour. I was about 17. And just started to sort of coach. Eventually, I set up this workshop, and I went to the leader of the band and asked about, well, can we get funding for this? And we managed to get government funding for it, because it's a charity. And I ended up doing this workshop. I turned it into a workshop where I would teach the singers the songs, and then they'd get to go out and sing with a big band each week in the rehearsal, which was invaluable experience and learning. So I got to about the age of 19, and then this little 16-year-old, curly-haired, podgy Amy Winehouse turns up, and she was so moody, and she'd be like this as I'm talking to her, and I'm like, Amy, are you listening? And she really wound me up, and then she'd go out and she'd sing with the orchestra and she would smash it. So this is how the sort of celebrity vocal coaching started. So Amy, I'm sure you're all fans, was just a one-off. Incredible, even at that age, at 16. So I'm 19, she's 16, I'm coaching her, and it just starts to escalate. So I carried on coaching her. We went on to have an amazing relationship, and obviously absolutely devastated by what happened. And I think it devastated our community as musicians, because she was one of us, you know? Did you feel that? It was just like, she was one of us. She would go down Ronnie's and she would go to the open mics, and she did it the hard way, like we've all done, and she cracked it, you know. And so that's why it hit the community, our industry, so hard. Everyone knew Amy, you know. So from there, then I would go on, and then recommendations would happen, and I just started teaching, doing my own private coaching. And then I started, you know, Warners would ring me, the label Warners, and I would coach artists for their label, and then EMI, and then Universal got wind of it, and I just started coaching for artists on these major labels. Anyway, I'm watching X Factor about 4 years ago, going, that's my job, that is my job, like, I'd be perfect for it, I know I would. And I was like, right, and I sort of made it my mission to go and get the job, basically.